Everyone, welcome back to another tutorial in Kotlin. So in this tutorial we will see exception handling, we will see map, we will see list. So let's start with exception handling. So first I'm going to declare two variables. Let's define the of n type. Oops, what's happening? N type and variable number is also n type. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a input from the user and we will divide both these numbers, and then we will see if our divisor is equal to 0, then we will throw exception. So let's take a input from user, divisor equals readline line dot do int. Okay, now why I'm doing this, if you don't know what is this, readline is just a function which takes the input from the user and in form of a string, so we need to convert that thing. And if you want to know more about this thing, you should see my previous video. Number one as readline bang dot do int. Yep, now let's enclose them in try catch block, try ctch catch and exception and boundary. Okay, now if let's say divisor equal to 0, we will throw an exception. So throw an exception, let's say ex. If you don't know what kind of exception it is, you just write exception and rest it will handle. Let's say can't divide by 0, and else we need to println. We will say num divide by divisor equals, we write this num divide by div divisor. Okay, now we need to catch the exception. Exception, where are you? Oh, sorry, exception, and we will print the exception, right? Oops, so you all tried this, seems fine. Let's run the program. As you can see, first we need to mention the divisor, so let's say 3, and then we need to mention the number. Let's say the answer is 4. Okay, that's right. Now let's run it for one more time. Now we'll say 0 divide by 12. Okay, so here is the answer. So now we will see list. How to define a list, how to add, clear, remove and all that stuff. Let's get started. In order to make a list in which you can add or delete things, you need to make a list, a mutable list. So let's name it my list as, oops, my list as, let's say mutable. Okay, mutable list of type in and equals mutable. Oops, you need to write space mutable list of, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 52. Now I'm going to add an item in my list. My list dot add, let's say 8. So let's print the list. one thing I can do, I can start a loop. Let's say I in my list, and for that I just need to write println. So let's say items to be what is the name of my list? My list. What say, let's print it. So here is the output. Now let's do more with lists. Let's say my list dot right, remove at let's say 0 1 2, let's say 0, remove at 0. Let's do one more to my list dot remove element, let's say 2. Then I need to declare a new list, let's say sublist out of a new list equals what's the name of my list? My list dot sublist from 0 1 2 2 to 0 1 2 3 4. Let's say 4. Okay, now again print this list. I can do one more thing. If I don't want to run the loop, sublist dot for each n, let's say I need to print those in sprintl and items slash n. So I need to give a space before this thing in order to distinguish. So slash n, and let's run. So here we have our another list. Okay, let's do more. Let's clear the list. What else we can do? Sublist dot clear, and let's print that again. Okay, now let's run it. So no output for the sublist after we clear it. So we have done overview of the list. Let's do map. So map is nothing but it's just a list, but with extra feature. Like we have here in map, we have a key value in order to distinguish between the list items. So through that key value, I can get the value, I can insert the value, and we can do many more stuff. So let's try map. So where, let's say new map as mutable map. In order to make changes in the map, we write it mutable map. So list of mutable map of let's say int. And if I don't know what is a variable or what will be the variable, so we can write any. It can be any, right? It can be string, it can be int, it can be double, and question mark. Okay, here it goes. So I need to add new. Let's add items in new map. New map dot. Let's say key value 1. This is syntax. This says store a new map with a key value 1 and a value, let's say a v, and let's say new map at 2. Let's say, can we store an integer? Let's see what happens. Now let's print this one. I'm going to use the previous technique for each. Okay, let's try for loop only to make it easy. I in map. Okay, new map. What I can do will return me index n as well as value. Index means it will return me key value. You can write like this. println, let's say primary value, primary key, or let's say key as hash I, and let's say value as v. Okay, let's add one more item in it. Let's see how it works. New map at 3, I'm gonna write, let's say April. Okay, now let's run the program. So you see it worked fine. Now let's do more with it. Let's add a value in it with a using a get. Okay, no, not get, let's say put. I say key value, let's say 4, and let's say June, or let's say insert a float 0.23. okay, now let's remove new map dot remove, let's say key value of 2. Now new map dot, let's say, okay, this is enough, let's print the list. Map, let's run the program, and it worked fine. So let me make it more clear. Session, let's run it again. So earlier I was having at key value 1 I was having a V, and then 23 and then April. Now a V, April, and 1.23. Now let's say, can we override it, or can we replace? Let's try replace first. Map replace, let's say 3, let's say 3 with June. Okay, and can we override? Let's do that also. New map dot put at 1, I like to put maybe INSH. All right, now let's copy this part and let's see if it works or not. And paste, run. So it worked fine. As you can see the output. So that's it with the maps, lists, and exception handling. If you're liking and enjoying the videos, hit like, and thanks for watching.